So she's basically running at home and representing Jamaica. PT Usha is a lady that some people think could win this race from India in lane 5. 55.54 her time in the semis. Debbie Flintoff in lane 6 from Australia. Tuija Helander of Finland will be in lane 7. And then the only American to qualify, Judy Brown, is... What about somebody like Usha or somebody else? Do you like anybody else's chances here?
Like you said, Usha, she ran a surprising win in that semifinal at that 55-54. She's in a great spot. She can see everyone. She can run off everyone else's pace.
Really unheard of when she showed up in Los Angeles, 20 years old. The Asian continental record holder, but got no pre-Olympic publicity, really. And here she is with a chance to perhaps win the gold. We'll find out. They're really spread out in this field as far as the favorites are concerned, with Skoglund in one and Brown in eight, and then Usha in the middle. Once around the track, they stay in their lanes all the way. Women's 400-meter hurdles. Judy Brown, Michigan State graduate, living and training now in Eugene, Oregon.
Set.
It's a fair start with Brown in lane 8, and Flintoff has pulled up in lane 6, and it's also a false start. And it could be. Again, Brown in 8, Skoglund in lane 1. And among the others, El Mutwakil in 3, Usha in 5.
Set.
This time, a fair start. And they're just about even as they go to the first hurdle, with Helander looking good in lane 7. And also El Mutwakil looking very strong at the outset here in lane 3, Skeets.
In past races, El Mutwakil, she's only 5'3". She's a gutsy runner. And because she's so short, she really explodes in this first 200. She really sets the pace.
Here she comes into your picture. That is El Mutwakil from Iowa State, representing Morocco in lane 3. Judy Brown in lane 8 in decent shape. Here comes Skoglund now making her move, but it's El Mutwakil who has the lead as they begin to straighten out. Nawal El Mutwakil in lane 3 is out in front. Skoglund is second. Brown is fifth at the moment. El Mutwakil with one more hurdle to go. She chopped her stride, but still has plenty left, and she's going to win it. And here comes Brown up on the outside to take the silver medal and a blanket finish for third. I think it might have been Kojikaru of Romania. There's an upset.
Al, fantastic race by El Mutwakil. We didn't really think that she could have the strength and stamina because she's so short in stature, but she went out so fast, and that's another key to running this race. If you can go out fast, and a lot of ladies like to pace themselves off the front runners, but if you get too far in front of them, they can't come back. And as we said, Judy Brown, who has that tremendous fight.
Watch Judy Brown now in lane 8 on the outside. Her charge for second.
As we said, Judy Brown was in lane 8, and she really couldn't see anybody until she got on the straightaway. And this is where she makes most of her time in this race. She never gives up. She's running strong. She's very tall, very agile. Never gives up. Everyone else, I said, as Skoglund in lane 1 probably expended too much energy running the tight turn, and Judy Brown just puts her head down. And the race is never over until you cross the finish line. Not looking at anyone. She's just giving it all she has. This is what it takes to win a medal at the Olympic Games.
Look at that battle for third. It's clear that Brown wins the silver, and then we suspected that the Romanian, and when we look at the replay, I'll stick by that in lane 3, at least for the moment I will, in lane 2, Kojikaru. Also in lane 5, that's Usha of India. And as you can see, Skoglund appears to have finished fifth. But there's no question who won it and who finished second. Judy Brown from East Lansing, Michigan, has won the silver.